Oh, Campo got a lot of rain.
Okay, who's going to be the first person to see the monument? It's going to be dead ahead, 12 o'clock.
Dun, 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 dun.
There it is.
42, the answer to life, universe, and everything, right at the monument.
My name is Mikkel, known as Biz on Trail. And in 2019, I hiked the Pacific Crest Trail. The PCT stretches 4,270 kilometers through California, Oregon, and Washington, from the border of Mexico to the border of Canada. And this is my story. Like myself, most thru-hikers walk in groups, and these groups are called trail families. A trail family consists of the people that you spend all your day with hiking, and you share all the experiences the trail provides to you.
Oh my god, oh that's good!
And even though it took some time to get accustomed to living out in the wild, it was almost nothing but good times hiking through the desert of Southern California.
Seal? Please.
Oh my god!
That is not an animal noise.
That's like a Wookiee.
Oh, seal. Four guys.
Uh-huh. With a Gerber?
Yeah. It doesn't cut very well.
Dragon!
How do you feel, Brian?
I feel great.
Everton!
Brownie? Who wanted brownies?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Eventually, we made it to Kennedy Meadows. Kennedy Meadows is a special place. It's called the Gateway to the Sierra because it marks the end of the desert section and the beginning of the high mountains. It's a place of celebration where you can celebrate your accomplishment with other hikers, reflect on your journey so far, and start preparing for the real mountains coming up ahead. My first 700 miles on trail have flown by and brought plenty of new experiences and new friendships along the way. But it was not entirely without trouble that I made it so far. Every day brought new challenges, whether it was the wind. The heat. The blisters.
Not a rattlesnake.
Snakes and critters. Down trees on the trail, river crossings, all this snow. However, it was nothing compared to what was waiting for us in the High Sierra. mountains can be just as brutal as they're beautiful. But we stuck together and we made it through our first week in the Sierra. In town, we got reports of a long window of storms and bad weather ahead. They changed a lot of hikers' plans. The uncertainty broke trail families apart. Also mine.
We sit with the fools in the center. The jokers and the killers.
And even though it's just a part of thru-hiking, it is still very difficult to split the people you've been through so much with. After taking our goodbyes, Thor and I hiked back into the mountains, determined to make it through the snow.
And you can float on the way for so long. Someday, honey, you've got to come back down. And when you do, I'll be hanging around. Smells like smoke in here, and the piano doesn't play. It never did, and there's this feeling I get. When you're in the room, I want you to stay. Someday, honey, you've got to come back down. When you do, I'll be hanging around. And you can float on the way.
That's it, dude.
After 5 days of storms and cold, and by far the most memorable experience on the trail, we decided to change our plans. We need a drier trail, because Thor got a frostbite in his feet. So we decided to hitch a ride to Mount Shasta, the most northern trail town of the Californian PCT section, and to start hiking south to connect our footpath to where we left the trail. When you jump around on trail like that and change direction, it's called a flip-flop in thru-hiker terms. And what an amazing decision that flip-flop was. This is where we were joined by Sam and a few other hikers who also had decided to hike south. But after a couple of weeks of easy terrain, the trail started to get difficult again. And by time, the snow came once again. And this was troublesome because Thor's frostbite was still bugging him. His feet needed time to heal properly, and and by time, we were forced to say goodbye. With still 500 miles left to the exit point where we left in the Sierra, I soon had to say farewell to Sam and the other guys who I just started hiking with. They had decided to flip back and start hiking north again. But I was determined to follow through with me and Thor's plan, even though it meant I was going to hike alone through the wild Sierra and finish the flip-flop we set out to do.
Mange lokale viser, hvor der jo ikke er så meget stor politik. Malta bærer, det virker som om, der ikke sker så frygtelig meget på Malta, fordi de skriver rigtig meget om verden omkring dem.
I came back to a changed Sierra. The snow wasn't gone, but the roughly 30 days of sun we have had since we left definitely had its impact. I could now see the trees, the rivers, and the scenery just unfolded in a totally different way than it did before. Hiking on your own is definitely an entirely different game, especially mentally. But after some time, I found my footing and I got comfortable. It was a totally new experience.
Just crossed Carey Creek in the High Sierra, and that marks 1,325 miles on the PCT.
Eventually, I started meeting other hikers on trail again. The only problem was, they were all walking in the opposite direction. And while solo hiking is a really cool way to experience the trail, I found out after a while that I still prefer the company of other hikers. Solo hiking the Sierras tested me in every possible way, but I learned to embrace the suck and just get the best out of every situation. Exhausted, happy, and super proud of my accomplishment, I finished my flip-flop on the 4th of July, and I made it all the way through the Sierra. When I got into town, I really wanted a room, but because of 4th of July, everything was booked, so I had to set up my tent in the park. And one thing I apparently still hadn't learned was to look out for sprinklers before setting up my tent in the night. Crossing the border to Oregon brought me a new burst of energy. I was hiking with other people again. The terrain was easy, and I felt super confident about making it to Canada. I've been a beggar and I've been
been a king. I've been a loner and I've won the ring. Losing myself just to find me again. I'm a million miles smarter, but I ain't learned a thing. And I've been a teacher and a student of her. I kept my word for whatever that's worth. Never been last, but I've never been first. Oh, I may not be the best, but I'm far from the worst. Oh, I may not be the best, but I'm far from the worst. Oh, I've seen trouble more than any man should bear. But I've seen enough joy, I've had more than my share. And I'm still not done, I'm only halfway there. I'm a million miles ahead of where I'm from. But there's still another million miles to come. I'm gonna follow this
brick
road.
Cool.
And in a matter of only 2 weeks, I was about to enter Washington, the final stretch of my PCT through hike.
I know that there's a plan that goes way beyond mine. Gotta step back just to see the design. The mind feels the heart, but the heart doesn't mind. Oh, I may not be perfect, but I'm loving this life. Oh, I may not be perfect, I'm loving this
life. It is.
Oh, I've seen trouble more than any man should bear. But I've seen enough joy, I've had more than my share. And I'm still not done, I'm only halfway there. I'm a million miles ahead of where
you're such a hippie.
Thru-hiking is in many ways a bittersweet thing.
Holy shit.
5 months of epic adventures was coming to an end. And while the thought of finishing the trail, seeing my friends and family again, was purely amazing, I also knew that it would only be a matter of time before I had to find my way back out on the trail.
Have it, Mexico to Canada. Yes! Woo!